I can be crazy, I know. I can get down very low, but I can get up really high if you just give me some time. If you will be mine, I know it will all be fine. If you will be mine, I know it will all be fine. It makes me happy, yes. It makes me happy, oh yes. It makes me happy to spend my time with you. I can be lazy, I know, and I could stay home from the show and hope the band makes it.
I'm Adam McIntosh, and this is, tell me who you are.
Anna Sachs.
And the lovely Anna Sachs. Yes, indeed. We've been doing the Songwriter Showcase for about a year and three quarters. It's a very, very good thing. A lot of great songwriters in Door County and as far away as Chicago and Madison that come up here to play for us. So I'm very lucky to have as many great people around to play with.
So what distinguishes the Songwriter Showcase from just being an open mic is that everyone who comes and plays is playing original material. We do have an exception to the rule, which is that you can play songs written by someone else if you know them personally. So that keeps things interesting around here and keeps it kind of grassroots. So on that note,
the format, really quickly, of how we set this up is that we have each songwriter come up and do about three songs. We do it in groups of three, and then we take a short break to let people socialize and get caught up. And then during the performances, we ask that if you must talk, if you must turn to your neighbor and say, isn't this the coolest thing you've ever seen? Just say it under your breath, you know, don't talk over the music because there might be somebody behind you that's trying to listen. And a lot of these people that get up and play at this show will be getting up to play songs that they've never played before, first time performing them anywhere, so please give them your respect.
All right.
Just a question from the audience. Sure, you with the orange sweater.
What constitutes a song?
Yes, that would be anything with notes, chords, melodies, words.
You don't have to sing.
Yeah, I wouldn't say. Yeah. I guess there are people that have gotten away with not singing and being really famous for it, right? And just a quick safety notice, you guys, the back door here is open for you guys to go out and smoke and everything. But if you do go out that way, just be careful of the cables and everything that we have set up here for recording purposes. Just watch your step. Everything is taped out with red tape here. But do be careful.
All right. Put your hands together for Adam McIntosh.
We did a little recording of this song the other night at Recording Studio 330, Hans Christian Studio in Surgeon Bay, as part of a recording project class with a bunch of his students there. And it's been really, really a good time and a fun thing to do. So you can check recordingstudio330.com to find out about more classes next Tuesday, and the following Tuesday we'll be doing it again. And it's been a very cool thing.
Makes me happy, oh yes. It makes me happy to spend my time with you. Oh, I can be lazy, I know, and I could stay home from the show and hope the band makes out all right, 'cause I can't be without you tonight. If you will be mine, I know it will all be fine. If you will be mine, I know it will all be fine. It makes me happy, yes. It makes me happy, oh yes. It makes me happy to spend my time with you. This is amazing, you know. What we have now, we could grow into something we would like to live with the rest of our lives. If you will be mine, I know it will all be fine. If you will be mine, I know it will all be fine. It makes me happy, yes. It makes me happy, oh yes. It makes me happy to spend my time with you. Oh, it makes me happy to spend my time with you.
A lot of these songs,
at least a lot of the ones I'm going to play tonight, were written right here in Door County, and most of mine is Sturgeon Bay, some of them up north. Many of the people who come up here and perform tonight will have written these songs right here on the peninsula, and that's a pretty unique thing, too, I think. Door.
my ears. You belong to me like a queen bee in a marmalade.
Song is about. I would love for you to play the Telecaster on this next song. Hey guys, please welcome Mr. Pat Bohan, fresh in from Madison. Cool. Another song written on a 3rd Avenue.
Sing me a song.
You'll see a lot more of him later on. Hey, Seth Raddatz. Why don't you grab that Telecaster and come play a song with us? Hey, everybody, put your hands together for Seth Raddatz, Anna Sachs, and Mark Raddatz. Why don't you come up here and sing backup with us? It's a rare occasion that you get four people together to write a song. No, you can just put the celly right here. Rachel. The Jerry Donahue.
Microphone with a ladybug tonight. Oh. See?
Don't breathe it in.
I know.
But we found ourselves in a small room together. We were going to write two different songs. Anna was going to write one with Seth. I was going to write one with Mark. We figured it would be easier, to probably just write one since we were all sitting around a table. It was about a 10-by-10-foot room. Yeah. So, rather than write two songs, wrote one, and here it is. I'll do it twice.
If you get free tonight, come be with me. We can.
Beautiful. Mark Raddatz, Seth Raddatz, and the sax. I'm going to back down a notch. Put your attention up this way because you're really, really going to like the guitar playing of Mr. George Solly. Put your hands together for me, please.
Thanks, all. It's great to be here. Thank you to Adam and Anna for letting me participate in this tonight. This is cool. This is a piece that's been, I guess I've been working on this for a few months, and maybe a month or so ago, I finally got it recorded in its more or less final form. So I think this is going to be it. I'm calling this Spring in My Backyard. Thank you. I seem to have come quite a way since doing this the first time last March. I think I'm gonna do the first thing I ever played at the open mic back on back at Cafe Launch, and I do recall that I was shaking like a leaf because. And I actually said, good God, what is this? I've been playing for 40 years and I'm nervous. But it's really a different thing playing for weddings where nobody really pays attention and this kind of thing where everybody's like, you know, so that was a little bit scary, but I'm gonna go ahead and do this. Jeannie, you wanna come up and sing this with me? This is a piece that I did when I started hearing this Hawaiian slack key guitar music, and it doesn't really qualify because it's in the standard guitar tuning, which they never use, and I'm not from Hawaii, so you know it doesn't, you know, but I just wanted to kind of portray the feeling that I get out of it. I just really like the mood of that music, and even the stuff that's up tempo just had this, you know, this piece to it, and it was just very nice. So I call this Never Been to Hawaii. I was almost going to call it Never Been to Hawaii, but I kind of like the music. But I thought I'd get sued, so I'm going to leave it at that. And I've been doing it up here occasionally with Jeannie and her group. And she does a little bit of nice little sort of embellishment singing over it. And I really like it, so I'm gonna have her up here and do it with me. So, okay. Thank you. Just a moment. Just a moment.
I'm not going to get it.
Yeah. Let's put your hands together for Mr. Mark Raddatz and his son Seth Raddatz.
I'm up here in this attic room. Looks like it could use a broom. But it ain't what's on my mind. Wanna write a song today while all the kids are tucked away. I wanna blow my baby's mind. What's the measure of a man? Does anybody really understand? So maybe baby and a few close friends. When you ain't on the radio, you step around your life is smoking coal, as if the waves within means to an end. And the law will judge you by your day job, and we're long past the gold watch and fob. You better hope your riches sin if they haul you in. On fire. But when you ain't on the radio, they lean on you just like they know the justice is gone to hell down the road. So I'm up here in this attic room. Looks like it could use a bro. Oh, but it ain't what's on my mind.
From a project that I did with Chris Haley. We were watching, well, at least I was watching, too many Westerns that winter. And the project's called Tumbleweed Tales. This song is it's called Jesse. I was riding shotgun on the Overland Express all over the Midwest Plain. Seen lots of outlaws, but the one I remember best is the outlaw Jesse James. Heading out of St. Joseph, west along the trail. Seemed like an uneventful morning. Came across a fearful sight and made any man turn tail. Oh, wish he'd never done been born. Cause I was looking in the eyes of Jesse James. And he was riding with Brother Frank and the younger gang, wreaking havoc all over the Missouri Plain. Hey, what the South had lost, he was trying to regain. Our hands up high in the sky.
team came to rest. Something went high in the sky. I was looking down the barrels of about 16 different guns, thinking I was about to die. But I looked right in the eyes of Jesse James, and he was riding with Brother Frank in the Younger Games, wreaking havoc all over the Missouri Plain. While he was making his point, he was making himself a name. My useless sawed-off double-barrel down in the dirt. Soon a strong box followed suit. He tipped his hat to the only lady there, made all with cash, stole a horse or two to boot. But I was looking in the eyes of Jesse James, and he was riding with Brother Frank in the Younger Gang, wreaking havoc over the Missouri plain. Just another outlaw common folk could hardly blame. Though he robbed the stage this time, banks and trains were more as a line, hitting hard and moving fast as he settled score. Hiding out when times were bad, he drove the Pinkertons quite mad. They made a hero out of him, me and outlaw lore. And I was looking in the eye of Jesse James, and he was riding with Brother Frank in the Younger Game, wreaking havoc all over the Missouri plain. Since the day I looked him in the eyes, ain't never been the same. It's actually about a girl named Anna. She's my first girlfriend. So it's sort of a personal song, but it's also universal because it's about first love. She took off her faded jeans, tossed her raven hair. He couldn't help but stare at her as she was standing there. And she undressed him too, and they got into bed. Well, it wasn't so much the things they did, was the things they said. He said, you know I love you, babe, and I always will. She said, I'm yours forever too, and her words sent up a chill. So they hung out together, doing what lovers will. Guess she left him after a couple years and shed a few tears for the innocents killed. Heard it said a few times before. Nothing haunts you like your first love. As you're going through life's many doors, wondering what's become of. Well, that one you used to know, who said she loved you so. You better love the one you're with right now. You let the memory go. Well, he's married to a good woman now. She got a gentle soul. You might say that he's in love with her. Yeah, they're watching the children grow. But sometimes his mind wanders back about 38 years ago, just a couple of kids in love, in the words that still echo. Like you know I love you, babe. You know I always will. She said I'm yours forever too. In her words sent a bad chill. They hung out together, doing what lovers will. Yeah, she left him after a couple years, and shed a few tears for the innocents killed. Back down to Illinois, so that's where I was born. And of course, I don't recognize it anymore. And that's sort of a universal theme all over, too. The fields of my youth, they used to go on for miles and miles. Here in the concrete lies the truth, quiet desperation behind a smile. What did they do to the woods and the stream? The new strip malls stand wall to wall. Looks like the land of broken dreams. I guess that's what's left when progress comes to call.
I recall a father and son shooting down by the river, and again with a friend down on his farm. The rush of my first ring nigger roost a pheasant, and the thrill of a shotgun under my arm. Single shot 410 under my arm. Barely recognizable to me. Well, I see what they mean about you can't go home. But there's still some people there I want to see. Sometimes it's just fun to let your memories roam. Sometimes it's fun to let your memories roam. Oh. Of my youth, I used to go on for miles and miles. This is one of my more recent songs, so I wrote after watching a documentary on Pete Seeger, who's called The Power of Song. So I wrote this, and it's called A Powerful Weapon. Some people say music's for entertainment only. Go tell it to Pete Seeger. Some of his causes may have left him lonely, but he sang not just for rhyme, but for reason. And others say music's just for dancing and merrymaking. Go tell it to Woody Guthrie. If he saw cause or a risk worth the taking, he'd sing for someone similar to suffering. The poets and singers I'm talking about carved out their own time and place, speaking out against all senseless wars for equality and justice for every race. Music worth hearing is the kind played on mainstream radio. But this is the only drivel you hear in your ears. Brother, you got no place left to go. Though Dylan disliked the label protest singer, he sang many songs for the underdog. He sang for the poor and the disenchanted, and those unjustly treated by the law. Poets and singers I'm talking about carving out their own time and place, speaking out against all political wrongs and for equality and justice for every race. Many say music's just for money making. Go tell it to John Lennon. He gave us the songs, give peace a chance, and imagine, and believed in what he was saying. And to anyone who thinks music don't change nothing, go tell it to Lead Belly. It got him out of prison and back into living his life. A story's sure worth the telling. Poets and singers, I'm talking about, carved out their own time and place. Speaking out against all the social wrongs and for equality and justice for every race. Johnny Cash always seemed to say what he wanted, and it wasn't always the same old country fair. When he sang of the plight of the Native American, you could tell the man in black truly cared. And Victor Jara of Chile lost his life for his singing of songs for political justice. The people of Chile called him a hero, and they felt he was surely one of them. Poets and singers, I'm talking about, carved out their own time and place. Speaking out against all political wrongs and for equality and justice for every race. Song would be dull and boring, but it ain't just for rocking and high-stepping. Here's a dangerous idea I'll leave you with, my friend. Music can be a powerful weapon.
Thank you. Mark Raddatz, man. Come on.